بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين وعلى آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. هذه العبادات التي تعيشناها وهي محرمة كلها، الذكر باللحن والقرآن باللحن والحديث باللحن، العبادات التي تعيشناها وهي محرمة إجماعا كتابا وسنة وإجماعا، الذكر باللحن والقرآن باللحن والحديث باللحن والأدعية باللحن.
بسم الله.
هذه حياتكم، هذه عبادتكم.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We're back to the purification of the tongue, or the prohibitions of the tongue. That this is your daily life. This is your daily worship. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these sinful actions mentioned in the prohibitions of the tongue, of mispronouncing the Quran, mispronouncing the du'as, mispronouncing dhikr.
كُلُّهُ لَحْنُ.
All of it is error, untrained.
ولذلك يقول علي أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه قصم ظهري رجلان أثقل قطع ظهري رجلان كسر ظهري رجلان.
As such, علي رضي الله عنه said, as the Khalifa of the Muslims.
كسر ظهري رجلان قصم قطع ظهري.
Then my back is broken by two types of people.
عالم متهتك وجاهل متنسك.
He said, a scholar who is a deviant and a ignorant person who is acting as a worshipper.
جاهل متعبد وعالم متهتك.
A worshipping ignorant person and a deviant scholar.
إذن ما هي الحل؟
So then
ما هو الحل؟
What is the solution?
عالم ليس موجودا حتى يكون متهتكا أو متهتكا.
The scholars are not present for them to be deviant or upright.
إما جاهل مدعي وإما جاهل متعبد. جاهل مدعي للعلم وجاهل متعبد.
Either they are ignorant people claiming to be knowledgeable, or ignorant people rushing to worship based on ignorance.
فما سمعتم وكما رأيتم.
As you have heard and as you have seen.
أروني عالما.
Show me a scholar.
حتى يكون متعبدا ومتهتكا.
So that we can see if they are upright or deviant.
فلا نتكلم عن معدوم.
We're not talking about something that is non-existent.
إذن هو الرجوع من الكل على التعلم وترك الكبر.
So it all goes to actual proper learning and abandonment of arrogance.
لو اعترفتم جميعا بالواقع إلى قلنا نحن سواء ويلزمنا أن ندرس كل العالمنا وجاهلنا ودكتورنا ومحامينا والأمة كلها سواء كل سواء كأسنان مشط عليها أن تتعلم.
If you are being fair and truthful, then you will say the speakers and that you so-called sheikhs and so on, you will say that all of us, whether we're called sheikhs or laymen or normal people or ignorant people or anyone, we're all equal. We all need to learn and practice. We're all like the teeth of a comb. We're at the same level.
نعم. فمن يدعي العلم فعليه أن يتوب من الله يتوب إلى الله تعالى من الدعوة وهو جاهل يتعلم. ومن هو عام يتوب إلى الله تعالى محتاج يشهد الناس على ذلك وغطيته من الله. لكن من يدعي الواجب عليه أن يتوب إلى الله أمام الجميع يقول هذا أنا كنت كذابا دجالا واجب علي.
So the one who is claiming to be a scholar, he needs to clarify to the people, I was not
أنا كنت كذابا أنا كنت مسلمة الكذاب أنا كنت مسلمة
deceiving I was مسلمة الكذاب I was deceiving you I am not a scholar I need to learn and need to repent. And if somebody is ignorant, he doesn't need to tell anyone, he just needs to repent and go and learn knowledge.
هذا هو الواقع.
This is the reality.
وغير هذا لا يصلح الأمة الإسلامية الآن.
And other than this, it will not fix the state of the Ummah today.
ترك التعلم لكفر مفضي أو هو كفر عندهم بالمحض.
That the abandonment of knowledge or of seeking knowledge is leads to disbelief, or it is disbelief, it is kufr in itself.
لأنه الإعراض عن وحي النبي وصاحب الإعراض بالكفر حبي.
Because it is turning away, from the revelation of, to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the one who turns away from the revelation, that is the description of a disbeliever in the Quran.
ورفعوا لصوتي على القرآن والحديث لا يجوز ذلك من محرمات اللسان.
And raising one's voice also from the prohibitions of the tongue is raising one's voice over the Quran and over the hadith.
والذكر كل ذكر بذكر لا إله إلا الله والحمد لله وسبحان الله ولا إله إلا الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. هذه أذكار ثابتة مما في كتاب الله تعالى وسنة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم يلزم فيها ما يلزم في القرآن والحديث.
And then the proper pronunciation and of the dhikr that is known like لا إله إلا الله سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر.
لا حول ولا قوة
إلا بالله.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد.
This requires the same requirements of the pronunciation of the Quran, as in that it needs to at least be pronounced with the proper letters, just like the Quran and just like the Hadith.
نعم راوي أحاديث جوامع الكلم قيل لعطاء بن أبي رباح وهو أحد التابعين الذين قال فيه العلماء لا يفتوى عطاء في مكة كما قيل لا يفتوى مالك في المدينة قيل له ما هي مجالس الذكر قال مجالس الحلال والحرام أنت تعلم العلم هذا حلال وهذا حرام عطاء من أحد كبار التابعين بن أبي رباح قال العلماء لا يفتاوى عطاء في مكة الفتوى لا تصح.
And one of the righteous predecessors, one of the followers of the companions, Ata ibn Abi Rabah, who was the mufti of Mecca, that it was said, just like no one gives fatwa in Medina while Malik is present, no one gives fatwa in Mecca while Ata is present. He was asked about those gatherings of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said they are the gatherings of halal and haram. Knowing, as Allah said, this is halal and this is haram, knowing it actually. This is the dhikr, this is the remembrance.
إذا عرفت هل هذا حلال وهذا حرام صار ذكرك ذكرا وإلا كان ذكرك غفلة.
So if you know what is halal and what is haram and what to do and what to say, then your dhikr is actually dhikr. Other than that, your remembrance is actually heedlessness and forgetfulness.
لكن غافل.
If it was based on ignorance, then you're a person who is mentioning Allah, but you're while being heedless of Allah's commands.
Or ignoring his commands.
And if you did not know, and you do not see, and you do not seek the one who knows to ask them, then how would you ever learn? How would you ever know? And from the strangest things is that you do not know while you do not know that you do not know. And from the most wondrous, shocking, strange things is that you are thinking that you are remembering Allah when you mention Allah, but rather you are not remembering Allah. That you are heedless while you do not believe that you are heedless. This is the compounded heedlessness and ignorance.
في الغير أو أحاديث جوامع الكلم أو التعبد بمعنى هائم. واحد يروي جوامع الكلم كمثل إنما الأعمال بالنيات، وكمثل من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه، وكمثل لا ضرر ولا ضرار. أحاديث تجمع معاني كثيرة لا تنحصر في غيرها من الكلام، لا يجوز روايتها بالمعنى، حرام.
So there's something called riwayah bil ma'na, where you mention a hadith in accordance with its meaning and not in the literal wording that the Prophet ﷺ used. And this is not allowed for the hadith that are very concise and precise, such as la darara wa la dirar, or that or indeed that actions are by their intentions, or saying from the excellent Islam of an individual is the abandonment of that, or leaving that which is none of his business. Because these concise statements were from the special bounties given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the one who wants to actually present that meaning using other words, he will not present that properly. He will not represent what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said properly. فإن كان يقولها ولكن يقول لا يقول أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
يقول معنى الترجمة يقول قليلا.
He can say that maybe the translation.
But for example, when you mentioned the hadith where like actions are by their intentions.
Let me finish.
Okay.
That if you are saying the translation, or this is the translation of something, or you're talking about the concept, that's one thing. But to say you cannot say the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in words, and then you say in other words in Arabic, and you skew the words of that he said in the hadith that is from Jawami' al-Kalim. And then this, subhanAllah, is this is the case with hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the concise hadith. Then what do you think about the Quran? People, unfortunately, they say, "Oh, Allah says," and then they mention just something that they're making up the verse, subhanAllah. They're saying they're using words other than the words that Allah
says.
That I've seen people say Allah said, and then they use their own terms in when they're recording the verse, subhanAllah, and they don't even say it properly.
I was saying, what about like, for example, the hadith, like earlier you mentioned actions are by their intentions, but then explaining like whether or not that action, like for example, you were saying people say it's enough that they'll have a good intention for something that they'll do without any knowledge. So people often, they use the hadith, actions are by their intentions, by saying, "Oh, I have a good intention for doing something."
That's from their ignorance of the
hadith. That means they don't know the hadith. Basically, they don't know the
hadith.
هذا من الجهل.
So if people are ignorant of the hadith like that, then can't you, then aren't you supposed to?
هؤلاء لا يجوز لهم أن يأكلوا قالوا أن يتعلم.
Forget about quoting hadith. Those people cannot even eat bread without learning something first. They're not fit for drinking water. Forget about hadith.
هذا شيء آخر. خلق الله للحروب رجالا ورجالا لقصعات منهن، أو خلقهم الله لأكل البهائم الأنعام والذين كفروا يتمتعون ويأكلون كما تأكل الأنعام والنار مثلهم.
But these are people who are, forget about being made for a plate of food. They are, subhanAllah, taking the descriptions of the disbelievers that Allah says that they enjoy themselves and they eat like the animals eat and the fire is their end.
إذا واحد يقول هذا هذا أحسن أن يموت في الشارع.
If a person says this, oh my intentions are good, my intentions are good, and they're ignorant, then it's better for him to die in the streets.
هو لا يعلم ما هي معنى النية.
He does not even know what intention means. شيخ هل يكون من تزكية النفس المحرم أن يقول؟
هو ليس من تزكية من جهل النفس من أصلها. وما وجدت النفس حتى تزكى.
يقول ولا تزكوا في هذا هذا من
ولكن ولم توجد نفس حتى تزكى هذا كأنه من قطع الأصل هذا فوق ما قلت نعم تزكية النفس وعدم أيضا معرفة النفس
يعني
هذا من جهل النفس
is ignorant of their self entirely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids us from praising ourselves and saying that I'm pure and my intention is good and this and praising yourself and saying that attributing goodness to your soul and to yourself. And this is not just that, this is a person who is ignorant of even his self and his soul and of everything. And he's saying that intention is good. He doesn't know intention at all. What is the meaning of intention anyway? It is a meaning, it is a concept that is found in the heart, where the heart is tied towards a specific action, that means you're intending it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the proper way. Or fleeing from the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that it's done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fleeing from the punishment of Allah. Either doing it for the sake of Allah or abandoning it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this requires knowing what is pleasing to Allah and displeasing to Allah, of course.
وذلك جعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أصول الأعمال هي أصول الأعمال.
So this is why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has made it as the root of the actions and the foundation.
النية ليس بالسهل ابن الحاج كتب كتابا سماه المدخل لتصحيح النيات كتاب
ابن الحاج رحمه الله
أربع مجلدات أنا ممكن أوريك إياها
a book called Al-Madkhal the entryway to correcting one's intentions and it's four
volumes أربع مجلدات النية ليست هو حتى العلماء قالوا إما هي ما أنا معلوم نية ما فيها نصف العلم وثلث العلم
the scholars said that in actions are by their intentions
هذا الحديث فقط قالوا
This hadith alone is either half of knowledge or a third of knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
But you're playing with fire due to your ignorance. Everyone opens Riyad Salihin and recites But actually, the actions are by their intentions, the haram is by your speech. But your presence in this earth is haram.
في الغير للدار بمدلولات الفاضل أن يروي بالمعنى لغير أحاديث جوامع الكلم أو التعبد أحاديث التعبد هي كما قلنا لغيرها من الأحاديث كأحاديث الأحكام ليست تعبدية وليست جوامع الكلم من هو عارف بأساليب لغة العربي وكل كلمة يعطيها مقابلة جائز له أن يروي بالمعنى يا أنت كنت غايب معناها التعبد أو الجوامع انتهينا منه ما غير ذلك من أحاديث الأحكام التي ليست جوامع كلم ولا تعبدات فإذا كان الإنسان عارفا بألفاظ العربية وبلاغتها وأعطى الكلمة مقابلها فلا حرج في أن يروي بالمعنى.
So in regards to the hadith which are concise and precise, those hadiths it is not permissible to narrate them in other than their precise exact wording. As far as hadiths which are related to rulings and so on, for the people who are qualified and they're very strong in their Arabic and they know which words can be replaced with which without changing the meaning, and to clarify the meaning to the listeners, then they are able to do so.
نعم ومن روى مختلقا ولم يبل للناس وضعه بعصيان قلب واحد رأى حديثا مكذوبا به عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ورواه للناس هذا حرام لأنه كذب عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا إذا بين وضعه.
So also it is haram to recite a fabricated hadith that you know is fabricated unless you clarify to the people that this hadith is fabricated. Not weak, fabricated.
تحريم الشرع أباح كلمة خصص بتحريمه أو عما كذلك تحريم ما أحله الله كما قال تعالى لا تحرم طيبات ما أحله الله يقول ما علي حرام واللبن علي حرام والعصير علي حرام
That it is also forbidden to make haram that which Allah has made permissible, such as saying that milk is haram for me or water is haram for me or whatever. Or to say halal is haram for me. And to command haram is haram. What is an example? Of commanding people to do a sin.
I'll
tell you a
sin.
To tell the people, give us an example of that. What is an example of commanding people to do a sin? It's to tell people, you know, to for ignorant people to teach.
Treat them.
Come teach us, give us speeches.
تعال اليوم تذكرة الواحد من speakers من East Coast. تعال.
Today we have a reminder from one of the speakers from the East Coast.
الله لم يأذن لك في هذا الأمر.
Allah did not permit you to do such.
أما أنك تأمر به هذا شيء آخر.
As far as commanding others to do it and telling others to do it, this is something.
أعطينا درس الشيخ العلامة هلا.
Give us a speech, Sheikh so and so.
هذا أولا كله لا يجوز.
This, first of all of it is forbidden. He doesn't know anything. And you don't even know that he doesn't know. And you don't know that. And you don't know that you don't know that. And if you tell him to teach, then he's going to teach misguidance as well. So it is haram and haram and haram and haram. This is haram entering haram.
الأمر بالذنب أو يقول تعالى الأمور شاهد التلفاز
This intersection and combination of haram.
تدخل على التلفاز انظر التلفاز.
Telling people, you know, look at the TV.
الأمر بالذنب.
But you're commanding haram.
هو انظر الفيسبوك لواحد.
Oh, watch this guy on TV. Look at this guy on Facebook. Commanding people to do any sin. As for buying that phone in the beginning and giving it to your children, that's a different matter. That is called compounded sinfulness. Or go and listen to this person. His speeches are so good. Or go to that party that's such a great celebration. It is also haram to inform others of everything that you hear, just to pass on anything that you hear without verification. So just telling people whatever you heard on TV or Facebook or WhatsApp is all, this is haram. Just to relay whatever you hear. That in a hadith in Muslim, it is narrated that it is sufficient haram for an individual, of lying for an individual, to just inform of everything he hears. Because most articles are lies.
تخبر بغير ما غلب على ظنك أنه ثابت لابد أن تخبر تقول أنا سمعت ولا أدري هل هو صحيح.
So So if you are in relaying something that you're unsure of, you have to clarify, I'm not sure if this is true or not. I've not verified this. It is also from the prohibitions of the eyes.
That
looking at people with envy and jealousy, hatred, this is all haram.
نظر الناس باستحسان ما أحسن صحته وما أكثر علمه وما عقله فقط هكذا عاد وتقول ما عقله وما صحه وما أجمله فقط عاد العين هي العين تقول هذا واحد جميل جدا وهذا فاتر جدا عين يعني هذا
تقولها حسدا يعني
حسدا أو فقط إجراء على لسانك بدون تأمل لأنه واجب على الإنسان إذا رأى شيء يعجبه يقول فتبارك الله سبحانه ولو بدون تأمل.
So even if a person doesn't even ponder about something and they see something they like, they praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
هذا كلكم عين إلا من بور إلا من بارك وسمع سيقع العين.
So you see something in ما هو الحديث
كلكم
all of you are
الا من بارك وسمع تبارك معيان انا صاحب عين
so all of you are a giving evil eye except those who are sending baraka and the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
تبارك الله احسن الخالقين
so saying تبارك الله احسن الخالقين when you see something that you like
وفي عين حرام وفي عين تجري على الإسلام
there is the forbidden عين and there is the intentional one
ما كان عن حسد ومنية هذا حرام
that which is based on envy and jealousy this is an intent this is حرام
ولكن إذا وجدت شيئا عجبك
but if you see something that you like
لا تتسارع وتقول هذا جميل وما أجمله وكذا وكذا
don't rush to say that oh this is so beautiful and this is so great no
فإذا رأيت وقول فتبارك الله كما قال عمر الخطاب عندما سمع ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسر العظام لحما ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر ماذا قال عمر قال فتبارك الله أحسن عمر يعلمنا
say as Umar رضي الله عنه said instead
لما تعجب من خلق الإنسان وهذا قبل وجود هذا ما يجب عليه
he was amazed by the creation of how Allah سبحانه وتعالى
لا يجب عليه أن يفعل شيئا لأن هذا شيء معدوم هو أخبر الله تعالى عن شيء
in the Quran Allah سبحانه وتعالى details the stages
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين آدم من قبل
where a human being was created that Adam عليه السلام was made from clay
أول خلق الثاني ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين
then the other human beings how they were from sperm and then a clot and then so on all the different stages
ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة
then نطفة turns into علقة these are precise terms which are very accurate in terms of the stages of embryology
وخلق المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحما خلقا سويا
it turned created the bones and then wrapped the bones with meat and so on flesh
eyes ears fingers لما سمع عمر هذا قال فتبارك الله
so when عمر رضي الله عنه
قبل أن تنزل فتبارك الله عز وجل
heard this he was amazed and he said how exalted is Allah
أحسن الخالق.
Best of creators.
فأنزل الله فتبارك الله.
So then this actually was revealed actually as the end of that verse. فتبارك الله أحسن.
هاي موافقات عمر وقالها.
These are called موافقات عمر. وعمر's statements were in accordance with.
والحديثات تكثر كما وافق به عمر. سيوطي كتب نظما في موافقات عمر وقالها.
And Suyuti, he actually wrote something detailing these muafaqat of Umar radiallahu anhu. The Umar says and the Quran reveals confirming it.
فرق كبير بين من يغير القرآن ومن يوافق القرآن.
That there's a massive difference between those who are changing the Quran and distorting the Quran, and between the one Umar radiallahu anh, when he says something and the Quran confirms what he says. Allah does as He wills. There are people who are the Quran confirms them, and there are people who change the Quran.
Speakers, America, يغير القرآن وعمر يوافق القرآن.
The American speakers changing the Quran, and Umar radiallahu anhu, the Quran confirming him.
فرق. هذا هو الفرق بين الفرق.
This is the difference between the groups.
قومنا قامهم لمحبة.
That there are people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them for His love.
وقومنا قامهم لمضلتي.
And those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them what He gave them for misguidance.
قَوْمٌ ضَالُّونَ مَخْذُلُونَ وَقَوْمٌ مُوَافِقُونَ.
People who are misguided and abandoned, and people who are receiving the help of Allah.
إِذَا كُلْ مَا وَجَدْتَ شَيْءٍ يُعْجِبُكَ فَقُلْ فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ.
So then whenever you see anything that you like, you say, فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. And you say, مَاشَاللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ.
طيب.
لا بس. He says, مَاشَاللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ, that's also good.
وَمَنُّنْ لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَةٍ. كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, حتى تكون الصدقة مَنًّا. هذه مشكلة.
فهل يحرم إذا يقول لأه سبحان الله, ما هذا يعني جمال و...
ينبغي يتوقف. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جاء واحد صحابي وقال كأنه أذان, فأخذت الحمى, قال لا يسارع أحدكم يقتل أخاه, وما كان عندي سيئة.
That, yeah, you should be very careful in just praising without mentioning the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a manner, because this is something the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has warned against.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next thing, which is haram is of the tongue, is men. Men is where you do a favor for someone and now you come to hold it over their heads. The mentioning of favors that the Prophet mentioned, that this is going to be in the last days, that any goodness people do, that they want to show it off, they want to hold it over the heads of the people who they help. From the signs of the
day.
And harming the people, this is also haram.
لا ضرر ولا ضرار. لا تضر الناس.
There's no. Do not harm, bring about harm.
وَأَذَمْ وَلِلْأَذَاهَ مِنَ الْوُجُوهِ كَمْ وَكَائِمْ وَكَذَا وَالْأَذَا كَذِيرٌ أَنْوَعُهُ.
And there are many kinds of harm.
كَالْهُزِي إِسْتِهْزَاء.
Such as mockery.
إِسْتِهْزَاء. فَيَسْخَرُونَ سَخِرَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ وَلَمْ عَذَابُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they make a mockery of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mocks them, and for them is a severe punishment. And scaring others, threatening others.
When
you'll see, you'll know who I am. Scaring others, threatening others for no reason.
Is this Muslims or Muslims only?
And the scaring and and threatening and so on.
والبهتان.
And spreading لies about people. False accusations. These are all types of harm. That you're putting a person in a bad situation and embarrassing them in front of people, this is all haram.
يا المسكين يبهت وما فعله ولكن ما عنده خيار. أنت عندك نوع من الذكاء حتى يعتقد الناس أنه فعله. مسألتين.
That now that you make spread lies about an individual, that you say that, oh, this person did this and this and this and this, And you leave this person embarrassed in front of people and he can't defend himself. And you're lying about him both and and hurting him and embarrassing him.
كالوزي والترويع والترويع والتقافي وغير ذلك من الأصابع يحرم في حضوره وغيبه هذا كله حرام في حضوره وفي غيبته.
All these types of harm are haram either in the presence of the person or their absence.
لكن قبل هذاك الشهر لا
تذكر الشهر كان روزي هنا 22 فسيكون 23 23 فسيكون تحت ذلك لا لا
يقول كم
23
So yeah, it's missing in the PDF as well. It just goes 22 then
24. كذلك مدح الإنسان حرام كذلك مدح الإنسان مدح الإنسان أمامه إلا لأمن ضربه إلا يقترب من هذا المدح لا يؤديه إلى ضرر ولا يؤديك أنت إلى ضرر لا يؤديه إلى وقوع في حرام ولا يؤديك أنت إلى وقوع في حرام.
And this is all haram in front of the person and behind their back. And also praising somebody is haram unless you know that it will not lead you or them to haram.
بدون ممدوح إلا لأمن ضرره بدون ممدوح إذا كان سيؤدي ذلك إلى ضرر في دين الممدوح هذا لا يجوز هو الغالب لأنك إذا مدحت كثيرا من الناس يؤدي ذلك إلى فساد الدين.
And unless you know for sure that this is not going to lead them to haram, as in
يغتر يعتقد الكمال ويعتقد الصحة ويعتقد الفضل على غيره.
The majority of people when they are praised, they think that, oh, I'm so great and I'm better than others and my actions are accepted and I'm a good person and so on. And this is all... Or it leads to the corruption of the person who is praising because he's lying or compromising or making things up.
يحصل له الحجب وله الغرور بنفسه عندما يمدح.
Or the person even who's praising, he thinks all these things about themselves or all هذا الشرح الذي قلناه.
نعم كعشب. كالعشب يقع للممدوح.
Or the person who's being praised, thinking that
الحجب وله الغرور بنفسه.
they become conceited and full of themselves and
بسببك اعتقادي الكمال يفتر من اي يخفف الاعمال ويتراخى ويكسل.
Then because now they think that you know I reached my destination and I'm such a great person.
كم فعلت من الخير الماضي وكم أكملت من المقاصد ومن المشاريع.
That I've done so many things and fulfilled so many functions and helped people and so on that they think that now you know I can take a break.
break.
So it really would break them.
هذا يكون break هذا break كسر هذا كسر له مسكين.
So it would break him. And it wouldn't give him a break. That this would lead to so much.
اسمعوا سيد خلفاء الراشدين كلام.
Listen to the. This would lead to so much harm. Listen to what the Sayyid of the master of the خلفاء he said.
من ذلك؟
Who is that, anyways?
تعلمون سيد الخلفاء الراشدين من هو؟
Do you know the master of the خلفاء الراشدين? Who is he?
من هو?
Prophet
Abu Bakr. 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 Abu
Bakr. Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. Abu when he was praised, he would say, O Allah, you know myself more than them. And I know myself more than them. You know myself more than me, and I know myself more than them. So forgive me that which they do not know. Meaning that he doesn't accept and he doesn't believe the good things people are saying about him. He doesn't believe that about himself.
وكيف يعتقد الإنسان الكمال بنفسه ولو بلغ مقام أبي بكر؟
So then, how can a person think goodness of himself even if he reached the status of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه؟
لذلك أبو بكر رضي الله عنه كان يقول يا ليتني كنت كهذا الطير يأكل من الشجر ويشرب من الماء.
As such, Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه would say, I wish I was like that bird that eats from the trees and drinks water and that's it. It's not held accountable. No accounting, no nothing.
بدون ممدح أو المزكي فيفتر ذلك المزكى معنى الممدوح يفتر يتكاسل الأعمال وينافق المادح هذا يقع دائما يكثر من
So the one who is being praised becomes insincere. And the one who is praising is not just insincere. The one who is being praised is not just insincere, but he doesn't try as hard afterwards. And the one who is praising, he's insincere and hypocritical. And he lies. This is the state of the people who praise others. Always lying.
لا يتركون الكذب ذكر الكرامات هذا حالة المتصوفة هذا الآن نحن نتكلم عن المتصوفة ذكر الكرامات
هذا بعد هذا
نعم ذكر الكرامات الآن سننتقل إلى فساد الصوفية المتصوفة
then now we will go to the corruptions and the
المتصوفة المدعون
the forbidden acts of the tongue in relation to the people who claim Sufism who claim tasawwuf who claim spirituality
ما عندهم من التعلق بالله إلا الدعوة على الله.
The only connection that they have.
إلا الدعوة الكاذبة على الله.
To spirituality or to Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
لا أعلم أحدا أضل من الصوفية.
False claims about Allah. I do not know anyone who is more astray than the Sufis of today.
قال ذكر الكرامات واحد يقف تعرفون ماذا وقع لي كنت أنا سمعت شيخ. أو ما عبره شيخ عبد الله سبي شيخ وهل قال كنا في السنغافورة وشاءنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في المكان الفلاني عند باب المسجد الفلاني وعلمني هذه الصلاة
سبحان الله
اتفو بك انت أقول أين ما كنت وأيا ما كنت ومن أين ادعيته
And somebody says you know سبحان الله we are in Singapore
عند المسجد الفلاني.
Such and such masjid and the
هذه الصلاة علمنيها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم himself came and taught me this prayer, this salawat.
وجماعة يعتقدون أن أنا أفضل الصلوات.
and his group thinks that this is the best way to make salawat on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
واحد يقول أنا كنت في النوم رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لي كذا وتوضع على فيسبوك وعلى فيس تايم وعلى فيس النار وعلى فيس.
Anybody claims to have a dream that I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he taught me this salawat and he makes something up and then he put they put all over Facebook and.
وجماعة ينشرونها على فيسبوك ليل ونهار.
Then him and his group are spreading it.
أنا لا أعتقد جزما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سيرة.
I really doubt and I believe in a completely that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not see this person. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not aid the sinners. He does not increase the sinners in disobedience.
ذكر الكرامات أصلا حرام إلا إذا أذن لك الله تعالى بإشارات كثيرة عند الأولياء.
So then mentioning these miracles, mentioning these karamat, this is haram, one of the prohibitions of the tongue, unless Allah سبحانه وتعالى makes it very clear that they should be mentioned.
هذه إذا وجدت أحرى إذا لم تكن كما قلت لهم إذا كانت لم توجد هذه الحالة.
And that's if those miracles are real miracles, it's still haram to mention them unless there's a reason and a clear indication. So what if those miracles are false anyways?
عندما تجدون الآن الكرامات الأولياء دائما يقولها لخواصهم فقط وأشياء عند الضرورة جدا ما كل وكل مجالس فقط مملوءة ما شاء الله هذا ترتيب رباني ومشينا بكل سهولة الأمر.
Then this is something, subhanAllah, that if you look at the awliya, how did they, how were their miracles?
خوفهم من كرامتهم كما قال الرفاعي. قالوا كانوا يستحيون من كرامتهم كما تستحي الحائض من ذكر حيضها أمام الناس.
But they would have such shame and embarrassment in regards to their miracles, as the person, the woman on her period would have to say to others, oh, "Hey, I'm on my period," publicly.
لكن في أمريكا ليس مشكلة.
But in America, of course, that's not even an issue. So, unfortunately. And so then this was their way when, unfortunately, the people who claim to have these miracles today, they will say in front of a whole mass of people, and they'll say things like, SubhanAllah, we were at that place, and the Prophet ﷺ came to us, and then we started flying. There's a guy who says these things who has millions of followers. If I said his name, you'd know him.
كلها في سنغافورة. سنغافورة ما سيتي
يعني بصراحة.
خلونا من سنغافورة. هذا
الكذب.
هذا
سنغافورة.
هذا المشاكل. هذا الكذب.
But we were in Singapore.
تدجال.
That you are a deceiver.
أعوذ بالله منك.
I seek Allah's refuge and protection from you.
شو سنغافورة اللي تجيتها أنت؟ شو سنغافورة؟ شو ما؟ ذكر كرامتي إذا لم يذني به له أحرج لم تكن. قال الجنيد السالك رحمه الله تعالى قال ألطف ما يبدع به الولي الكرام.
الجنيد السالك may Allah have mercy on him said
هذا هو رئيس الصوفية.
That he is the head of the Sufis. He said that the most subtle thing that a person, that one of the awliya is deceived with is his miracles. This is the scariest, the most serious test for the awliya is their miracles. I seek Allah's refuge from the devils of humankind and jinn.
تزكيه النفس هذا مرض الصوفيه ايضا تزكيه النفس استخاره.
Claiming one's own piety and righteousness, this is one of the other ills of the Sufis today.
تزكيه النفس هم كانوا لا يذكر احد منهم خيرا عن نفسه ولا نصار كل شيء تزكيه النفس قلوبنا طاهره.
The state of the Sufis before was self-accusation. And they would never mention that, oh, I'm so great and wonderful and so on. But subhanAllah, now everyone says my intentions are great and my soul is purified and I'm basically...
Allah
So it is from the prohibitions of the tongue to claim purity to oneself. Allah says, and do not claim purity to yourselves, do not ascribe purity to yourselves. He is the one who knows who has piety.
التي بجميع إنجازاته أمام الناس هكل تسكين نسوه وغطئها ومسكين مشؤوم أنا أقول لأنه يظهر بلادته من باب التسكين ولكن كل ما له بصيرة ولكن بصيرة ليس الموجود يرى أنه جاهل جدا.
And then unfortunately now people are known, for example they graduate from Al-Azhar and they come in front of everybody and they show these are all my ijazas and emails and so on, how many sheikhs gave me ijazah and so on, and I'm this and this and that.
أنا جيت عندي شهادة من ديفيس, عندي شهادة من ستانفورد, عندي شهادة من بروكلي. ليش لماذا لتحترم وتعرف من أنا؟
And I have a degree from Davis or Berkeley and Stanford.
هذا أول ما يقول
الخطيب.
أول ما يقول الخطيب على المنبر هاي.
So the first thing that the khatib says on the pulpit is that I'm this and graduated from here.
أنا أحذركم من أنا ما عندي إجازة.
And I warn you from now that I don't have a degree.
أنا ما عندي إذن.
I don't have an ijaza.
ما عندي إذن للتعليم.
I don't have the ijaza permission to teach.
احذروا مني.
So beware of me.
ما عندي إذن للتعليم أصلا. وما عندي إجازة وما عندي شهادة وما درست جامعة ولا جامعة ولا سنت.
I don't have a degree or a certificate. I never studied at a university or an academy or anything like that or a center.
هذا مجهول في مجهول من مجهول. ترجمة. مجهول في مجهول من مجهول.
That I am unknown from unknown and unknown. And in regards to the people who they say that this was my degree and this and that, subhanAllah, the thing is, especially from Al-Azhar, they're saying that I graduated and I have this ijazah and that. And anyone who really looks at this person carefully with any type of perception, they're able to see that this person is ignorant. I was sitting in a dentist's office.
جاء من الأزهر وقابلت واحد من مصر من جماعة الأزهر.
And I encountered one of the people from Egypt from Al-Azhar.
قال نحن سمعنا عنك أوصافا جميلة وكذا أنا ما أعلم.
And he said, oh, we heard such great things about you, and he's not telling the truth. You know, he doesn't know me.
أنا لست مشهور حتى يعلم الناس.
I'm not famous that he would know me.
ممكن يكون سمع عن بسمي.
Maybe he heard my name.
لا أعتقد أنه ما عندي صفات أصلا حميدة ولكن ما أعتقد أنه
I don't have any praiseworthy attributes.
And
he said, you know, we have two masjids and so on, and I teach in one of the masjids, and you know what my specialization is? It's in tafsir and Arabi. I'm not even trying to study with him. Why is he telling me his
qualifications? I didn't talk about anything.
In regards to knowledge, didn't ask him about anything Islamic.
أنا حتى ما قلت أمامه لا إله إلا الله.
And you say لا إله إلا الله in front of
him. دخل معي مجال العلم أنا تخصص التفسير العربي. يعني.
And he said I'm specialized in تفسير العربي.
وأنا أعتقد اعتقادا جازما أنه ما يعرف العربي ولا التفسير.
And I know جزما. For sure that he does not speak Arabic.
ولا يعرف التفسير.
He does not know تفسير.
قال تخصص التفسير العربي.
So I do not know why he's saying this, but it, like as if I'm a student who's trying to study with him. And I do not know of any reason why he would say this. Besides the riya, I don't know of any type of reasoning for what he's
saying. بقراءة تزكية النفس كنا في شرق أمريكا وأنا كنت أدرس درسا عادي يعني فيه وعظ وفي أشياء واحد عراقي وقال لي يا فلان أنا عندي تعليقات 15 تعليقا هذا مثال خلال نصف ساعة 15 تعليقا
هذا أي
في Pittsburgh, في شرق أمريكا.
And the East Coast in Pennsylvania, in Pittsburgh, or in Pennsylvania generally.
بس في كثير من الناس.
There was a lot of people in attendance, and subhanAllah, during the speech, 30 minutes into the speech, there was a man who raised his hand. An Iraqi man who interrupted, who he said, I have 15 comments on what you said. 30 minutes in.
هذا فقط أقل منه. قلت له أنت إذا كنت ابن عباس أنا سأدرس معك وإذا كنت أنا لا أفهم أنا ما قلت شيء حتى إلى التعليق.
So I said that if you are ابن عباس then I'll study with you, but other than that I didn't say nothing to you. I need 15 comments.
أنا فقط يريد أن يدهش الناس. أنا لا لا لا. أنت تريد تلعب عقلي أنا لا.
But he simply he wants to play with people's minds and.
أنا قلت لهم يا أيها الجماعة أنتم دعوتونا لا أريد أن أعرف الرجل ولا يعرفني ولكن إن كان ابن عباس أنا أريد أن أدرس معه.
So I said, oh people, you know, you're the ones who invited me here to talk, and I didn't come here to meet this guy.
لا أريده لا أنا ولكن إذا كان ابن عباس أنا سأدرس معه يأتي ويجلس في مكاني.
But of course, if, mashallah, he's ابن عباس, then I want to learn with him. And he was quiet after that.
أرجو إما أن تكون عباس لا أعرف أحد قد يفهم إلا ابن عباس حقيقة صعبة.
ما شاء الله في
تابين خلال 30 دقيقة عجيب.
One comment every 2 minutes ما شاء الله.
ما شاء الله. وتعرف الإنسان إذا أراد الجنون جنون فنون.
If somebody wants to be insane, there's mashallah all types of
insanity. جنون فنون. ولكن أعطي لكل فن فنه.
But give every specialization.
إذا كان يقول أنت ابن عباس. يا كان رجل قل أنت ابن عباس
إذا كان like this ما شاء الله really tell him you're ابن عباس
ويا كان رجل متخصص في العربي والتفسير قل أنا أريد أطلب منك العلم إنه أنت ما شاء الله
and if there's the man who's ما شاء الله really specialized and expert in عربي and تفسير then tell him ما شاء الله will learn from you
ما تحتاجني ودعاني أقول ما تحتاجني أنت ما شاء الله يعني
right then you don't need me
لا تدعوني لماذا تدعوني
Why would you invite me if you're so
كل واحد شو ويريد أن أعرف عنه أنا ما أعرف حتى ما عرفت اسمه إلى الآن ما سألت عن اسمه.
And I don't know his name until today. I didn't ask him for
أنا ما سألت عن اسمه. ما سألت عن اسمه. لأن من عادتي إذا رأيت الناس لا تحنهم لا أكرههم.
Because I see that people when I see people are in the state, I really hate it. I really don't like it at all. As soon as somebody says, oh, I studied this and that, and I'm not sure
this.
This is really an indication of their ignorance. If you have something beneficial to say, it's going to come out in your words. You don't have to be, mashallah, sharing how
important
an authority you are. Right, the bride is a bride. She doesn't need to tell people I'm the bride. It's obvious. Right, there's perfume and mashallah.
It
should be obvious in her dress and all of that. The scholar is a scholar. And the idiot's an idiot. The ignorant person's ignorant. This is all obvious. The ladies, can you hear me? I'm sorry, I'm.
Yeah.
الله يبارك فيكم جميعا ونحن سنوقف الآن ونرتاح أنا عندي تعب شوي بارك الله فيكم جميعا ووفقنا وإياكم لصالح الأعمال والأخلاق وفقنا الله وإياكم لصالح الأعمال والأخلاق وفقنا الله وإياكم لصالح الأعمال والأخلاق وبعد المغرب نبدأ الدرس
إن شاء الله then here we'll take a break I'm a little bit tired so then inshallah we'll continue after المغرب
someone sent a question he said if a person people who have a dream with specific instructions from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam they can follow it themselves but they are not give they don't give those instructions to others is that correct
كان عندهم يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اتاهم في المنام واخبرهم باشياء معينه يفعلوها فعليهم ان يفعلوها لانفسهم ولا first of all it needs to be weighted in accordance with the Sharia. It needs to be understood that this is something that Allah commands me anyways or not.
Imam Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, rahimahullah ta'ala, jaa wahad wa qala lahu, ana ra'aytu mimma yara an-na'imu, annani al-kanz al-fulani, al-rikaz, akhudhu ala nafsi, ma ana dafn al-jahiliyya min al-dhahab wal-fidda.
that he noticed
Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, Sultan al-Ulama, Sultan al-Ulama.
He was a Sultan of the scholars. He was approached by a person who said that there's such buried treasure from al-Jahiliyyah, from before Islam, that I was that I was told in my dream that I'm supposed to. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told me in my dream that I'm where it was for me to take it for myself. And he said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us before he left this world that that money is not for you and it is for the Bayt al-Mal, for the Muslims.
Go home. Go outside.
Get out of here. You're lying, basically.
Yeah. It's not easy to work with scholars. I mean, it's hard. The ulama is jahazin. It's lying. The ulama is jahazin.
You can't miss with scholars like that. You can't just...
خلق الله الحروب رجالا ورجالا لقصعة من ذريد. الله خلق من الحروب.
That they're ready for your nonsense. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Indies...
أو جعلوا رجال حروب.
Men who can handle battles. And this is a guy who's just specialized for eating food. So they say, so just tell them, get out of here, we're not ready for you.
I'm not saying if they're actually telling people about their dream, I'm saying if they see it themselves, what are they supposed to do about it? Like, it's a dream for themselves.
So first of all, the Sheikh was pointing about the first point, which is to wait in accordance with the Sharia. So number one, wait according to the Sharia, and if it's something like telling you to do a sin or something injustice and so on, then it's obviously wrong. Second of all, then you go and you ask somebody who's qualified to answer and explain it to you, and many times, even if you're being told directly something, it's actually an indication of something entirely different.
سيأتيكم هذا في تعبير الرؤى. الإمام مالك رحمه الله تعالى رأى أنه يؤذن إلى المغرب.
Imam Malik, for example, saw his dream that he was giving adhan for Maghrib.
وكان لا يعتقد كل ما يقول المسلم يعتقد إمامته ولكن لا ليس أمرا كان لازم عنده إنه يعرف أن كل شيء يقول المسلم صحيح معبر الرؤيا. كان ما يعتقد كل شيء يقول المسيرين يعتقد إمامته ولكن ليس من الناس اللي يهتم بالرؤيا جدا.
ابن السيرين was an
imam تفسير الرؤيا
of explaining dreams, but he didn't really have as much respect for his.
اللي يعرف إنه إمام وتابعي وخير كثير ولكن لا يفكر عن الرؤيا كثيرا الإمام مالك.
He didn't know too much about him. He knows that he's an imam and so on. He didn't know how specialized.
وأرسله خادم وقاله كل مرة أنه يؤذن إلى المغرب ماذا يقع.
So then he sent a servant to him that asked him, what happens to the person who he sees himself making adhan for Maghrib? He said, go back, this dream is not for you. He said, somebody else saw this dream, not you. So then he went back to Imam Malik and he told him. So he said, go back to him and tell him that Imam Malik is the one who saw this dream. So he told him that your madhab will spread in the West.
واحد آخر جاءه وقال أنا رأيت فيما يرى النائم أني أؤذن.
So then another person saw نعم he told him ابن سيرين.
نعم قال أنا رأيت أني أؤذن أؤذن فقط.
He said I simply saw أذان. I was making أذان.
كان رجلا صالحا.
He said that this is a righteous man.
قال ستحج.
He said inshallah you'll go to Hajj.
وحج طبعا.
And he went to Hajj.
كما قال تعالى وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق.
As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, make the call to Hajj, and people will come from every on every conveyance from every valley across the world. And another person, he said, I saw that I was giving an end in my sleep. أَنَّهُ يُؤَذِّن فِي النَّوْمِ.
نعم كمين ذلك.
أن يؤذن يعني فأرى في المنام. And he said, I saw a dream that I was making adhan. He said, you're gonna steal. Because he saw the state of that person is not befitting of anything else. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and a caller called out, أَذَّنَ مُؤَذِّنٌ بَيْنَهُمْ أَيَّتُهَا الْعِيرُ, that a gathering of people, a caravan, you are thieves.
كل بحسبية تعبير الرأس يتكلم عليها، لأن المهم إذا كانت رؤيا موافقة للشرع وطيبة وواضحة ممكن تفعل ذلك إن كان ما يظهر، ولكن أحسن تعرضها على أحد من أهل الخير حتى يفهم لك معناها.
So then the meaning
إذا كانت نافية شيء يعارض الشرع هذا عادي.
The point from all this is that if it's something very simple and direct that you're supposed to do and instructions to do something that is not contrary to the Sharia, then you will then you can do it. But it's better always, as you can see, it's easy to misunderstand something in your dream. So it's always better to run it by somebody who understands the deal. And it has to be from the people of knowledge and righteousness and understanding.
So the next question is, can you explain what you meant about speaking over the Quran? So if the Quran is on the car speakers, do you mean that the passengers cannot speak with each other?
يعني إن كانوا يعني يسمعون القرآن في داخل السيارة فهل لا يجوز للذين في السيارة أن يتكلموا؟
يرفع صوته فقط لا يجوز يتكلموا بخفية ممكن، وهذا إعراض أيضا شيء من الإعراض ولكن ليس كله. ما أن يرفع صوته ما لا يجوز.
So to raise their voice over the volume of the Quran, that would be forbidden in that case if they're playing Quran in the car. But if they speak quietly to each other, this would be better, but it's still not good to speak when the Quran is being recited. Because Allah says that if the Quran is recited, then listen carefully to it and remain silent so that you may receive Allah's mercy.
Sure. Some people, they say to play like Surah Al-Baqarah in your house at night, or like to protect your house from jinns or something like that. So when you're playing this the Quran, can you talk while the Quran is being played?
Don't raise your voice over the Quran. And to speak over it is not allowed, but to speak while it's going on, this is. I mean, if it's far away, it's fine. وإن كان وبعض الناس يسمعون القرآن وهم ينامون يعني كل
لو ناموا ما في حاجة.
And if people sleep while the Quran is being recited, there's no problem.
لا إله إلا الله أهم من هذا أوجب عليكم أن تقرأوا فرائض عينكم.
But more important than all this is to learn your
Quran. لو متم وما قرأتم البقرة وما قرأتم النساء وما قرأتم الملك لا يسألكم.
If you died and you hadn't ever read Surah Al-Baqarah or Surah Al الملك
أو النساء أو الأعراف أو الأنعام أو الزلزلة أو الناس مهم تحفظوا الفاتحة وتطبقوا فرض عينك.
The important thing is that you learn the Fatiha and you fulfill your فرض عين.
هذا أهم شيء للعوام.
That's the most important thing.
القرآن جيد وهذا ما لا عين رأت ولا سمعت ولكن لمن هو أهل له.
That's the most important thing for the layman. The Quran is so wonderful and so full of goodness and blessings, but for the people who are qualified. Don't worry too much about even reciting the Quran a lot until you learn your fard ayn. Most of the companions passed away without memorizing the Quran. And absolutely they are better than us and more virtuous. Because they were concerned with that which is more required of them.
Mm-hmm.
And the most important thing is Allah's pleasure. It's mentioned in a hadith sahih that it is often that a person recites the Quran while the Quran is cursing him.
لا يطبقه لا يستمع له لا يفهم معناه يخالفه يعصي الله تعالى يرفع صوته عليه يلعنه.
That he is not attending to it and he's disobeying Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
يعتبره ككلام غير عادي.
And he's disrespecting it, looking at it like just any type of
speech.
Just its nice sounding sounds.
القرآن يلعنه.
Quran curses him.
وَإِذَا قُلِ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Allah says,
هَذَا كَلَامُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ ثَقِيلٌ.
Once the Quran is recited, then listen carefully to it and remain silent.
أَتَقِدْ أَنَّكَ فِي عَالَمٍ آخَرٍ.
View yourself as in a different world.
أَتَقِدْ أَنَّ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ يُخَاطِبُكَ.
And believe and realize that the Lord of the worlds is addressing you.
مرابط الحج رحمه الله تعالى كان يتابع أحد طلابه وما كان الطالب يراه في طريقه إلى المسجد. كان يمشي
خلفه. رحمه الله was walking behind one of his students and the student wasn't aware that مرابط الحج was behind him.
والقارئ يقرأ والمرابط الحج من شدة فهمه للقرآن القارئ يقرأ وصار المرابط ينصت ينصت لقراءته.
And the qari was reciting.
Student,
and the student who was in front of him was reciting the Quran.
ابن عمتي خبير بالقرآن أعرفه.
And it was my cousin who was that student, and he's a very eloquent, very mashallah, well.
Pronunciation
is excellent in the Quran. So Imran al-Hajj was behind him. He was listening to his recitation.
ولا يعلم به ما يعلم.
And he doesn't know that Imran al-Hajj is behind him.
القرآن يستمع نوره. فلما وصل إلى باب المصلى.
And he was listening until they reached the doorway of the
Messiah.
And he was reciting about the destroyed nations.
وعاد وثمود
ثمود and
أصحاب الرس وقرونا بين ذلك كثيرة.
من أصحاب الرس؟
قوم جماعة هناك أصحاب الرس معروفين.
And many nations in between. And all of them we have placed them as examples or placed for them examples.
And
all of them we destroyed completely. So they reached the message of the Musalla at that time. So then Murabit al-Hajj said, be careful, Sidi Mahmoud. So he thought maybe there's
وما كان يرى المرابط احذر احذر احذر
احذر he said be careful be careful be careful so he thought that maybe there's a scorpion or a snake or something
قال ما هذا
he said what is it
قال القرآن يخاطبه
he said be careful the Quran is addressing you
أنتم تريدون الكمبيوتر صوت جميل فقط
you just want the computer to play something that sounds nice
وأنت هناك تشاهد التلفاز وتأكل مع زوجتك وأولادك تلعبون.
While you're watching TV over there and playing with your wife and kids.
سورة البقرة في البيت الآخر.
And سورة البقرة ما شاء الله.
أي إعراض فوق هذا عن كتاب الله.
But what turning away from the Quran is there over this?
تلعبون بالقرآن ما تستمعون القرآن تلعبون بالقرآن.
But you're playing with the Quran you're not.
هذا كلام الله.
This is the speech of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
And then another question: do you?
أنتم من شد أنتم ما صاحبتم العلماء المشكلة قالت لي بنت باكستانية طيبة قالت نحن من شدة عدم الصحبة نحن ضالون مشكلة كبيرة عدم الصحبة ما عندنا صحبة في طالبة طيبة قالت نحن ما عندنا صحبة أصلاً.
One student, she said, "Subhanallah, the problem is we haven't accompanied the scholars. We haven't seen. We haven't waited."
لا ما لم نرى أحد يطبق الشرع.
The living deen we did not see, so we.
لا نرى من يطبق الشرع.
We do not see the people who are actually implementing.
ولا من يخاف الله.
Or those who truly fear Allah.
محاضر على الكرسي يلعب بدين الله ويرجع.
Speaker on his chair. Playing with the deen of Allah.
صفاته كل صفات الغرب يعني قلادة.
And all of his attributes and his descriptions.
لباس لباس الغرب يعني قلادته قلادة غربي.
And everything about him is Western.
اسمه الدكتور من خريج من فلان.
Even his necktie and his title doctor so and so.
نحن ما عندنا صحبة أصلا.
So she said we don't have the صحبة the accompaniment of the.
اسمعوا أنتم تعرفون إمام دار الهجرة من هو من هو إمام دار الهجرة.
Do you know who the Imam of the land of migration, Medina is.
Malik?
Imam Malik.
من رسخ فيه المخافة?
Who ingrained in him the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
اسمعوا كلامه عن الذين اللي قابلهم.
Look at his description of the people who he met.
عندما كان عندما يسمع الكلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتغير لونه. يقول ما هذا الحال يا أبا عبد الله.
That when he would hear
فقط يسمع اسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
the name of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
يصفر لونه ويبيض ويتغير عن حاله
turn pale
قالوا يا أبا عبد الله نراك ترى تكون في حال غير الحال الذي كنت فيه أولا
and he is told oh Abu Abdullah we see your color changing we see your state is changing
قال لو رأيتم فلانا الذي رأيت ما قلتم رأيت فلانا وكان إذا ذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جف لسانه وكان فلان صاحب دعابة ومسح معنا فإذا ذكر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بكى حتى رحمناه وكان فلان يقع كل أي المدرسة التي أنا تخرجت.
Then he said, "You haven't seen the people I've seen. I've seen such an individual."
لو رأيتموه ما سألتموني.
You wouldn't even ask me about what I'm doing. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would be mentioned in front of this man, and he
كان يضحك معنا ويمزح.
Right before that, he was joking and with us and so on. And then after that, he's just, he turned he turns into a mute. And the other one, the Prophet ﷺ is mentioned, and he starts crying until he until we feel sorry for him. And if you just even see Zayd ibn Aslam, you would know that he is a person who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was drenched and covered in this this covering of taqwa and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by those people that
he said.
A person needs that accompaniment of the righteous.
If the Quran and the Sunnah without musahaba, la ta'rif ma huwa shay, ma ta'rif shay.
The Quran and the Sunnah without that accompaniment is you will not know anything of it.
The Arab يقولوا من جالس جالس.
And the Arabs, they say, whoever sits with someone, they take their characteristics.
Wallahi min ladu faraqtu muradhah ma ra'aytu ahadan athara 'ala 'aqliyati mutlaqan.
After I swear by Allah that there is no God but Him, after I separated from Marabat al-Hajj, may Allah have mercy on him, I have not seen anyone who changed my mentality after him. Not for a moment. Because in the knowledge that people learn is just simply drawn, you know, printed facts and information.
معلومات الله تعالى قال بل هو آيات بينات في صدور الذين أوتوا العلم.
But Allah says that it is clear verses in the hearts of those who are given knowledge.
ابن عطاء الله السكندري قال لا تصحب من لا تنهضك حاله ولا يدلك على الله مقاله.
ابن عطاء الله السكندري, he said that do not accompany the one whose state of being doesn't remind you of Allah and his speech doesn't lead you to Allah.
انت ما تجد واحد يجي يجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تقرا شمائل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كله ولا تجد واحد ياكل اكلهم ولا يجلس جلوسه ولا يمشي مشيه ولا يخالط الناس مخالطته فكيف تفعل تقرا كتاب الترمذي كله بالشمائل.
And that you can read the entire Shama'il and you would not see someone who is
حتى لا في الجلوس ولا في الأكل ولا في الأخلاق ولا في الكلام عن الناس. كل ما قرأته بشمائل الترمذي لا تجد مثالا له.
All of what you're going to read in Shama'il al-Tirmidhi, you're not going to find a person who is like that.
أنتم كم ختمتموه؟
How many times did you finish it?
أنتم كم ختمتموه؟
You, how many times did you finish it?
أنت أبو أخي.
والله لا أدري. مرة ثلاثة مرة
هذا ما هل رأيت ثلاثة أشخاص يفعلون شيء من فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ هذا بس إن الرواة بما بلا بفهمين لما عملوا من جمال عليه يحمل الوداع ثلاث مرات من كتاب الشمال تمين أنت ما رأيت مثالا أعمى أصم أبكر.
Two three times you finished Shamal Tirmidhi. You haven't seen you haven't seen someone for 1 hour doing the actions of the Prophet
sallallahu.
What benefit is the Shama'il al-Tirmidhi there? These aren't the attributes of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You heard something and you saw something else.
ليس الترمذي ولا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Those teachers of yours are not the Tirmidhi or the Prophet.
ما رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الترمذي ما رأيته. ترأيت كتاب شمال الترمذي وما يمكن تتصف هو كتاب.
All you saw was the book. It's not a description.
ما يمكن تتصف كتاب كتاب جفير.
You cannot copy a book. A book is made out of papers.
أنت ممكن copy these people. أنت ممكن تتمثل بهؤلاء الناس.
That you would copy those people, the teachers.
هؤلاء مختلفين عن الكتاب الذين درسوا فيه.
Who were very different from the book they were teaching you.
أنت سمعت شيئا ورأيت شيئا.
You heard something and you saw something else.
هذه مشكلتنا. هذه مشكلتنا.
This is our problem.
نحن نقرأ شيء ونرى شيئا آخر. خلاص.
Did we hear something and we do something? We see something else.
ولذلك الله تعالى قال: أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم وأنتم تتلون الكتاب أفلا تعقلون.
In this regard, Allah says that you command people towards righteousness and you forget yourselves while you're reciting the book. Do you not comprehend? How can you change people when in the gathering you're one thing and in the restaurant you're somebody else
entirely?
That you and the book even are differing. The book is Islamic and you're westernized. So what are the students
of knowledge?
You're far from the book that you're teaching. That this book is describing the Prophet sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam.
And the Quran is describing the companions.
وينزل على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it is revealed through the Prophet sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam. وانت الآن الغربي هو اللي تحدث ناسا من الغرب.
And you're some westernized individual addressing a western audience.
وتريد أن تتبع القرآن لأفكار الله.
And you want to bend the Quran and twist it to fit the western ideas.
ماذا سيتغير بالشباب المسلمين؟
What will change? How will this affect the Muslim youth? They will increase blindness upon blindness.
There's one last question. There's one person he asked, is it only the awliya that have the knowledge to interpret dreams?
Without knowledge or not awliya is. That there has to be knowledge and action that are those are the conditions. It doesn't matter if يعني هل الناس يستطيعون أن يعبرون الرؤى و.
الناس خاصة.
It's very specialized people.
سنتكلم عليها. سنتكلم.
إن شاء الله we'll mention.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Is that the one?